Okay, so welcome guys. Today I've got another ship to show off with Alexandros de Great, and he wants to show his buzzard today. So let me just go into the catalogue and we will look through for the buzzard. Blizzard. There we go. It's weighing in at 372 million. Not enough credits, it says. We're going to type slash give underscore credits. And then we're going to type my name. And then I'm just going to type in 400 million, because that should be enough. Okay. Boom. And we'll just give it a second to load in. This ship is called the Blizzard. And I forgot the slash, apparently. Slash. Right, there we go. The ship is called the Blizzard. And as you can see, it's a pretty big ship. It's gargantuan in terms of size, if you ask me. It's pretty damn huge. I'm liking the colour scheme on it, although it's very bright with this texture pack. I think that's just the specular lighting is probably a little bit too high. Even though I have got the sun there, so maybe it's just the sun. Hang on. No, it's definitely glowing too much. It should look like that. Anyway. So, yeah. That's looking nice. I have no idea where you're going to get in. Let's have a little scan around. See if we can see any doors. I'm liking the detail on the crystal and the choice of the white and black with blue. Nice, blends in with the grey. It's a cool colour scheme. It's a cool detail which he's ended up with here. Not many uses, and he's not using wedges much, so it's interesting. But you don't, not everyone uses wedges. So we've got a couple of AMCs poking out there. You've got no idea what could be behind. An almighty amount of AMCs here and here. So it's quite a flat pattern, but also widespread. So I don't know if he's got more behind there. It'd be interesting to find out. So let's see if we can find any plex doors. Any plex doors along here anywhere? Can't see any. It's a puzzle. Oh, there is no door. Let's just have a look at the vital statistics. So, for this particular ship, what we're looking at, the length 230 meters, height 39 meters, width 200 meters, the mass is 93,000. Okay, so yeah, the mass is 93,000, that's huge. The power is 24.5 million total. The recharge is 6 million energy per second. Thrust 98, so just a little bit more than its mass. The shields 5.3 million total, with a 55,000 shield per second recharge, and the recovery is 5 seconds, which is not surprising for something this big. He said there's not really much of an interior, so it's all right though, to be honest, because it's such a big ship. Like, what do you do with it? And it looks like he's just filled it with hardened hull. So this thing's like just a beast of armor. Okay. Oh wow. Okay, it kind of snaked in on itself. So he's actually got two different patterns there. So let's see, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. It's 21, but one side is not as powerful as the other. I think that's probably because of his orientation. He's probably not exactly, he's not exactly head on it. So that's why that is. It's sort of, it is actually, if I rotate my perspective slightly, yeah, you can see his left side of the ship is closer to the target, which is why it's penetrating more. It's only ever so slightly, but it is ever so slightly closer. So that was the single click. very nice. It's interesting how it's forked outward though, so I'm going to go up above for the 1 second. Okay. Well, it's the same version of a second as before, so I'm going to assume that actually they are genuinely firing for a second, and it's the lag which is causing it to seem like he's firing for longer than a second, because that is consistent with what I've seen with Hailstorm and my own tests. So very nice. If you see the pattern for this, it's almost as if they're curving inward. I reckon he's got more AMCs back there that I can't see, probably in the middle, and making it that U-shape. So, okay, that's just gonna have a look at it from the side, and it's as expected, it's flat because the ship is pretty flat, and you know, yeah, so it's good. It's almost like you can almost guess what it's going to be. Right, so sustained fire, here we go. Ah, there it is. Here it comes. So he's making light work of it, but again, we can actually see where he's firing from this time. I'm going to fly up there a little bit so you can see all the different firing points. Yeah, there are some coming out of the middle, and there's some coming out of each side. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, about 9 different banks of AMCs. Okay, so space folded and ended up putting me about 4.5 kilometers away, which is a big space fold. Okay, so now we can continue this test. So, he's taken the core out, so I'm going to go down there and save it. Now, what's interesting about this, which is something which I've learned from doing more of these tests, is that the shape of the pattern is what determines the shape of the pattern on his guns is what determines the ability to penetrate through these blocks. Now, what's going to be apparent when I show you, as you can see, if you look at the corner, he's actually had to take out the entire corner. If you look at the pattern there, he's had to take out the whole block. Like, the amount of block removal versus penetration is high, but the penetration is actually quite low because it takes time to remove all the blocks. Whoa! What am I colliding with? I'm colliding with bullets. Obviously, if you're just looking to destroy somebody, you want a shotgun design that's just going to scoop big chunks out so that they lose power, lose thrust, lose cannons. All that sort of thing will happen when you lose big chunks. But when you're if you're a salvage type, and this is like a hardcore server, you don't want to destroy all those precious materials, so you probably go for some kind of cutting laser that's just going to pierce through. The previous ship, although it was better at penetrating, would still, you know, not be the perfect design for penetration, but you can see just by comparing this guy's two ships, this one does more actual block count damage. Where, you know, it's removed physically more blocks. Okay, it took longer, but that doesn't really matter, because at this point, you know, we're simulating projected attack. And this is only stationary targets, so we can get a good readout on what the patterns are. And then read into that a little bit more, but you know, I like people to draw their own conclusions. Right. He's a pirate. Whoops! I made him a pirate by accident. My bad. Oh my god! Look at... what? Okay. He's passed that one with flying colors. Okay.
Mike entering a Mark 8, targeted. Reticle closing in. And
it's a bit unfair. There's no... okay. It's a bit unfair. They don't really get much of a chance, do they?
No, they don't.
The games begin. Whoa, he just charged. That migraine trigger just charged in, collided, got huge chunks taken out of him. I've got to make sure I don't get primaried here. Oh, it's coming in for another run. Jeez, it's like a kamikaze. I think he's done it. Has he done it? It's still firing. He's got some serious shields on there, though. I don't even think this... I don't think that even the... Yeah, that's done. Isn't he done? He's not done. He's coming for me. I'm going to hide around the other side of this guy's ship. Dude, can you kill it, please? Whoa. The trigger's getting down and dirty. That trigger isn't firing very much. I think it's got power problems.
Well, it might. Let me see.
It's firing. Ooh, trigger's got no shields. He's having trouble keeping up with it, though. It's quite maneuverable.
Yes.
Nah. He's gonna win this.
Uh-oh. It's something...
He's shooting at me. I hate that. Like, I try to get close so I can get a good view of what's going on. And he primaries me. He switches target. See, I'm sort of hiding in the shade of his ship. But if I misjudge it, he'll start shooting at me. He's coming on a death charge. He's on a death charge. Got to hide in the shadow. I'm glad this thing's so big, actually. Oh, wait. There's damage. He's getting damaged, dude. He is getting damaged. Yeah, sure. The Defiant comes in to the rescue.
Or tries.
This one's evil. I don't understand why this one's doing so much better than the last one. Oh, he's primaried you, buddy. That should give him time to realign on the target. I'm trying to chase it.
I've lost some thrust and shields.
Well, that's not good because he's looking at you.
I've only got 296.
Oh no,
thrust.
He's looking at me! Where'd he go? Where's he going? Uh-oh.
Good news, I still got my guns.
Uh-oh.
I've lost sight of him.
Oh! Let's have a look and check out this guy, because this guy did well. Both missile computers, too. Wow. So, basically, this one actually did really well. We're going to despawn it and get another one. Right, we're moving in on the target. Oh, wow, he's firing missiles and... additive speed isn't on. The trigger has not engaged. Here we go. It's in. The trigger's in play. Oh god, I'm on the wrong side of it. What happened? Whoa, he's got mad damage on his ship. Why is your ship damaged? What happened? Buddy. Oh my god, he's got a massive chunk. The Hailstorm design is way OP.
Well, I see a lot of missiles way, way, way over there. I just can't tell what's going on.
What? I'm by your ship. You took a nasty hit there. Dude, this thing had like 4 million plus shields. In round 3, took severe damage, and I think it actually managed to get through to his core. Yeah, it did. Holy crap. Look, there's a massive chunks all the way through.
I want to see this.
It's nuts.
Weapons offline.
It's nuts. This ship's huge. That was only the Mark 8.
And...
get in build mode and have a look at the state. Have a look at this. It's just. It's like, whoa.
Oh, it looks like it got away. Hit. It looks like it hit him from behind.
It didn't. It hit him head on. I was recording it at the time. It hit him head dead on. Uh oh, this one's firing.
I'm lagging.
I'm dead.